You realize pretty quickly that it was going to be a special place.
It was a hit from the start. Eastern came to be by merging Gibsonville High with kids from McLeansville and surrounding areas of Eastern Guilford County.
It's always been a part of the community ever since it was built, and it's something that we've always been proud of.
But then one day,
it was hard. It was hard to see a part of our life just crumble.
School immediately sounded their fire alarm. All the students and all the staff members got out safely.
Last thing you want to see was something like that happen.
This is a big fire.
It was very devastating to all of us.
What are we going to do? Where are we going to go to school?
It was a special place.
These are my friends and my family.
But that was then. This is now.
We're really excited to kind of 2009 bring it up.
As the class of 2009 gets its first look at their new school, the collective soul of the young men and women here and those who have come before them has emerged with a deeper understanding and appreciation for how triumph can emerge from adversity.
I think it has made it stronger. I think the kids have pulled together, the teachers have been supportive and pulled together. And I think it's made us a stronger group overall.
And it's a relatively large group. For 3.5 decades, families in the countryside here surrounding Gibsonville and McLeansville have built a love and devotion for their school, its history and traditions, centered around, of course, their relationships with each other and the Wildcat spirit.
It came to the surface once the fire happened, and everybody came together.
Eastern High has created a common bond that has now withstood more than just the test of time.
I think we're stronger and we like understand each other better because we know we've all been through the same thing, so we all can relate to each other.
It definitely made us stronger.
The added strength came with the help of a broad mix of generous friends, neighbors, colleagues, and total strangers who saw a need and moved quickly to fill it. From kind words and deeds to hundreds of thousands of dollars in donations of computers, musical instruments, and the like. The gestures made an indelible impression on those who were already determined to spring back to a brighter day.
There's an expectation that if you go to Eastern that you're a tough person, that you, you're a good kid, you know, that you do what you're supposed to do.
And I tell a lot of our students who are sent out, you know, who come to Eastern from the city, they go all the way out here, and I tell them all the time, you couldn't be in a better place.
And this place is now renewed, built with the latest technology, offering among the best opportunities for its graduates to get a good education and realize their dreams. Once again with Eastern High, the community has a new crown jewel.
I'm looking forward to it. It's gonna be great to get everybody back into, you know, a school that they can call their own.
I'm excited to see the new building. The kids deserve it.
I think the new building is really going to give us a sense of pride to continue that tradition on.
Just being like back, like making the drive up, you know, Bethel Church Road, yeah, holds a very special place in my heart, that's for sure.
I feel certain that that's going to happen, that, you know, the community will rally around the new building and, you know, just lots more memories to come.
This place is community, and it's a family and it's home.